We're at the War Horses for Veterans facility in Stillwell, Kansas. We are joined by the founder of this gorgeous, gorgeous facility, Patrick Benson, Army veteran. Thanks for your service.
Thank you.
Now, Patrick, before we talk about the facility we're in now, which is going to be done soon,
yes,
tell us about War Horses for Veterans and why you started it.
Well, it's based off of, you know, exceptional horsemanship and providing opportunities for growth and providing those tools for personal and professional development for first responders, but then you have combat veterans. And that's where it's generated from. You know, with me being an infantry NCO, did 6 years, and then the invasion in 03, left, and it took about 6-7 years, and I realized what I was doing for a living was having a significant impact on me and the wonderful people that I'd met and mentored me. So that'd be wonderful if veterans had the same opportunities.
And now you continue to serve and provide those opportunities here at the facility. And I remember a few years ago we're here, and this wasn't here. If you just take a look around right now, this is a gorgeous new arena that's almost done. Tell us what's going to happen here. What's this going to be used for?
Oh, all kinds of wonderful things. I mean, the sky's the limit. I always say, you know, dream big and, you know, put the bar real high. So here we'll be able to use this place year round. This will be a climate controlled indoor facility. We'll be able to do all types of events, obviously training a lot for a lot of the horses and things of that nature, but we'll be able to bring vets in from all over the country year round now. And our wonderful Missouri weather during the winter time can be not the most pleasant place in Arthur's.
Right, but I mean, this is going to allow you to be able to, like you said, it be a year-round facility, which is very, very important.
Yeah.
And also, I want to talk about what's going to happen here. So why don't we take a walk, because you're going to have actually state-of-the-art kitchen, and you mentioned first responder programs. You're going to have
absolutely classrooms
back here. So here, I'll have you go ahead.
No, absolutely.
And come on in. We're going to take a look here. Now, tell us this room here, what's it going to be used for?
A lot of it's going to be our gathering space. I call it my incubator. You know, it's really, this whole place is kind of designed for that. You know, the kitchen, this area is going to be a very big, important part for us to teach and really grow. A lot of us need to be together to help us support each other, and we'd like to bring influencers and other individuals, and we've been very fortunate to team up with certain private individuals that actually did serve in the United States military, have been very successful and have teamed up to help us develop wonderful modules that are a great need for our service members and first responders, obviously.
I can't wait for it to be done. And also, I mentioned a state-of-the-art kitchen, which is going to be right over here.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Okay, this is, I'm crazy excited about this. Like, this is, I geek out about it. We're going to have a massive island down here in the middle. We'll have a 60-inch range. It's designed by a chef. Greg Oliver helped us develop this. And Portfolio, down there by Union Station and stuff, teamed up with us and provided their services and they just did an exceptional job. This thing is going to be state-of-the-art, residential, professional, and this is where the heartbeat of this place is going to be. And we will gather around here, especially after doing workshops or even teaching classes and things of that nature, and you'll become a sous chef. You'll be able to learn to work with a professional chef, making meals that you couldn't even imagine making. And your emotions are going to be all over the place after you get done and you're eating it. You can't even talk to each other. It's a wonderful thing, and it's important to bring that family and that community together. As you know, especially in the service, definitely in the field, food is a very, very important part. Mm-hmm. And if you really want to drive an Army, you got to feed them right.
Got a sustainment.
Oh,
exactly,
absolutely.
Right. Now, for those who want to get involved, who want to support your mission, who maybe haven't heard of War Horses for Veterans, but they need to, how can they get involved?
You can go to warhorsesforveterans.org, and obviously we're on social media, War Horses for Veterans, and I think it's WH4Vets on Instagram and things of that nature, but warhorsesforveterans.org, and then we definitely, on the 9th of November, on Saturday, we have our 5K, and that's at the Liberty Memorial, obviously a wonderful place to do, not hilly at all. Mm-hmm. If you've ever done it,
yeah.
Just kidding.
It's a good course.
It's a great course. It's a great cause. And the biggest thing about it, the funds and why we're doing it, and we're really going to be pushing, you know, obviously forward moving, is going to be for these first responders. This place is going to be, basically, we're building it to share it and give it over and let them have a place to, you know, help each other get through a lot of the stuff, obviously, we see on social media and what we see on the news. But they're doing a wonderful, very difficult job, mm-hmm. and we want to support our brothers and sisters.
Appreciate all you do for our veterans, first responders, brother.
Absolutely.
Anything else you'd like to add or mention?
No, you got to get out here.
Absolutely. All right. Thank you so much. Yeah, right. Definitely wonderful cause, wonderful program that you can come out and help support. And Stillwell, I'm Rob Hughes, KNBC 9 News.